I'm sitting here with my good friend Pete Mitchison, and we've had the chance to spend the last few days together. And Pete, you were telling us the other day, just that we're talking about some moments in your life when you were speaking in the other language, you're praying in the Holy Spirit, and somebody there in the meeting recognized what you're saying. I think the first one you're telling me was you're actually praying for somebody.
That's right.
Yes. So tell us that story. I thought it was fascinating. Yes. Tell me about that.
This was back in between 77 and 78. I had just come into Sydney with Pastor Frank Houston and his wife to join a team to start what is now Hillsong City, but it was called Christian Life Centre Sydney in those days. And I was running a life group, and in my life group were a number of university students from New South Wales University. And this Sunday morning, a couple came out for the baptism, and Carmel was from Cairo, a very stately, tall Egyptian man with a brilliant mind, and his wife, Vanita, was actually from Southeast Asia. And they came forward for the baptism of the Holy Spirit. And so I was praying for them, and as I like to do, I love to speak in other tongues. I think it's one of the great things that the Lord has given the church. And so I was praying for Carmel, and he was earnest, but there was nothing happening, you know. And I was just praying in the Holy Ghost, but in my mind I began to pray, oh Lord, do something here. You know, this guy is earnest, but he's not getting the breakthrough. And anyhow, the next thing, he had disappeared from underneath my hand. He was flat on his back and just ecstatic and praying in, well, I didn't know whether it was his mother tongue or other tongues, but he was blessed. On the Tuesday night in the home group, he testified. He says, Peter, he said, when you were praying for me on Sunday morning and you were praying in other tongues, he said, all of a sudden you turned into you started to speak in my mother tongue. And I wish I had got him, had Carmel to write down the actual words, but the essence of what I was saying in his mother tongue was, come on, release your faith, God wants to bless you. That's paraphrase. Yes. Today, and I still believe he has his position, but he's a professor at a university in Wollongong, south of Sydney.
Wow.
A man with a brilliant mind, but needed a supernatural act to bypass his mind and come into the blessing. So I was blown right out of the tree on that occasion. I've had two other occasions which were quite remarkable.
Okay.
In 79, we went to Bathurst, New South Wales, to plant the first church plant out from the city church. And we did most of our water baptisms in the local river there. And again, it was amongst students of a college of advanced education. And I was baptizing this young lady in water. And as my practice was and still is, I believe, for a prophetic word for every candidate. And this particular time, I gave a message in tongues over this young lady and then gave the interpretation. There was a gentleman who wasn't a part of our fellowship, but a Christian brother who loved our fellowship and came to just watch this baptism. And he told me afterwards, he said, did you know that you're speaking an old dialect of the Spanish language? And he said, the reason I know this is I have a friend that speaks it and I understand some of the words. Again, I thought this is incredible. And then we had a young...
So he identified to you a little bit of what you were saying.
Yes, yes, he actually understood it. The third occasion was a young man that we had begun to father and who now pastors in the state of Queensland had brought one of his Greek mates into the church. And I happened to be leading the worship as well as preaching this Sunday. And we were just in high praises, just... worshipping in the Spirit. And Peter's friend said to him, Pete, does your pastor speak Greek? He said, well, no, I don't think so. Well, I said, I understand everything he's saying. He's glorifying God in Greek. And that young man went back with his family to Greece, so I don't know what's become of him. But as Paul says, we speak in the tongues of angels and men, and we just don't know, you know. God just supernaturally does that. As a sign and a wonder, I suppose.
You know, it's just, I'm fascinated in those moments and the way that, as you said, a sign and a wonder that the Lord can often speak even to those who are struggling.
Mm-hmm.
And whether it be the case of the the young Egyptian man who heard in his own language what he needed to do to receive the baptism. Just an incredible thing. And there is great value in the baptism in the Holy Spirit. And I want to encourage those who are watching that if you have not yet received the baptism in the Holy Spirit, I want you to begin to earnestly desire that the Lord would fill you with His Holy Spirit.
Yes.
Now, I've not set this up, but Pete, I'm going to have you pause now and pray for those who are watching and just pray for them to receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. Would you do that?
Sure, I'd love to do that. I think that you have to understand that the Holy Spirit doesn't speak through you. It's you who do the speaking.
Excellent.
It's the Holy Spirit that gives you the language, the ability to pray. And I'll just preface this by when I was traveling in Crusades with the late Frank Houston in New Zealand, we were in a place and we were praying for 50 to 100 people each night for the baptism of the Holy Spirit. And I remember this case quite vividly. The young man was name was Roger, and I was praying for folk, and that people would come gloriously through into the baptism. But this young man was struggling, so they brought him to me, and I fixed my gaze upon him, and it was something that drew out a confession from him. He said, I suffer from inferiority and self-consciousness. And so I said, Roger, do you believe as I pray, God will break those inhibitions and release you and you'll come through? And he said, a real affirmative yes. And so I prayed for Roger. I didn't even get finished praying my wonderful prayer. And the next thing, he was speaking powerfully in other tongues. So if you're out there and you're a shy person or you're self-conscious or inferiority, just believe that God can break through those inhibitions and give you a baptism, an immersion in the power of the Holy Spirit, and give you a language to speak. So let's do that.
Let's pray.
Father, we just thank you that every good and perfect gift comes from you.
Yes.
We thank you that it's your good pleasure to give us all that pertains to the kingdom. We ask right now, those who, Lord, are asking for the language of the Spirit,
yes,
that, Lord, that you'll infuse them, that you'll empower them. Lord, there shall come forth a powerful language out of their spirit, articulated with by their mouth, by their tongue. Lord, that you'll touch and anoint their speech, that they might begin to glorify your name in the language of heaven. So, Father, we just ask for that release now, and we thank you in Jesus' wonderful name.
Amen. Amen. You just go ahead and continue to worship. Yield yourself and let that language come through you. Great just to sit here and chat with Pete, and we would welcome you to return to the site, and we have some other videos that we think will be a great inspiration to you. God bless you.